Weaver, good morning to all. And we were continuing with the chapter, The Snake and the Mirror. And again, today we are going to start further. So yesterday, what we have studied about that the narrator, who was a homeopath doctor, he was discussing his experience in a gathering when they were discussing about snakes. So he has mentioned that at one time when he just started his career and he has just entered his room after taking his dinner in a restaurant. Then ultimately what happened, there were a number of rats moving up and down the gables as well as the beams. So that was yesterday only we have studied about the setting of the story, where the narrator was living and what kind of room it was where he was spending his time. Now further I'm sharing with you the chapter screen. Now it is going to be visible on your screens. Also, so till here, first paragraph we have read. Now we are going to continue further. So let us start with it. Yes, students are still entering. I don't know why. Yes. So next, afterwards, I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. I opened the box beneath the table and took out a book. The materia medica. So now what he has told that when he has gone outside in order to take some fresh air, but it was not even a single leaf was moving. The air almost has stopped down. And finally he came into the room and sat down onto the chair. So when he sat down onto the chair, then he thought that what he should do. There was no other option for him. So ultimately what he has done, he thought in order to read a book. So as there was not much space in the room, it was a single rented room where he was living. So he has opened up a box in which he has stored his books, and he took out a book. Which book he has took out? The name of the book was Materia Medica. Let me enter the students who are coming late. So, finally, I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror, and a small comb lay beside the mirror. It means what this shows. This shows that there was a single table which can be used both as a study, and moreover on the table, some other things are also put which can be used in order to get him ready. For example, like comb and mirror. So, he opened up. So he sat on the table, opened up the book there, and there also there stood a lamp, a mirror, and a small comb which was lying beside the comb. It means that there was no hanging mirror in the room, and he has ultimately used to stand in front of the mirror which was lying onto the table and comb his hair. One feels tempted to look into the mirror when it is near one. I took a look. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. See, this is a natural human instinct that whenever you see mirror, you couldn't stop yourself. It couldn't help you out, or you couldn't help out in without looking into the mirror. You will definitely look into the mirror. So ultimately, he said, at that time also, I was not able to stop myself to have a look into the mirror. And during those days, he said, when I was a young boy or a young man, so at that time, what he has told that I was great admirer of beauty. Admirer of beauty means that I was always feeling that how can I look beautiful? During young days, the persons, usually they should be like that. I was unmarried and I was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. So he was unmarried. Naturally, this is adding another point to his good looks. That's why he wanted to be a good looking man. And moreover, he was a doctor. So naturally, he has to be presentable also in front of his clients as well as his patients, so that he can have a good impression over them. And ultimately, he said, I felt to make my presence felt. And I always wanted that wherever I should go, I should always make my presence felt, so that the people should come to know that this is a different personality. This is what everyone expects to be. Now, I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. Yes. So there was a partition in his hair and he was adjusting that partition. It means he was setting his, he was setting up his hair in order to look smart. Again, I heard that sound from above. Again, he heard that sound. Which sound? The sound of the moving of the rats. He thought that they were rats. Again, he heard that sound. So, I took a close look at my face in the mirror. I made an important decision. I would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. And yes, then again, he was having a close look into the mirror. He thought that I should look more beautiful. So what he did, he has made an important decision while looking into the mirror that he should shave his face daily because that growth of hair, it is diminishing his beauty and it is not making him so handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor. So this is the reason why he wanted to look beautiful, because he was a bachelor and moreover, he was a doctor. I looked into the mirror and smiled. It was an attractive smile. So then he smiled and looked into the mirror and he was admirer of his own beauty. He felt that he is looking not bad. I made another earth-shaking decision. Earth-shaking means another strong decision he has made at that time. What was that? I would always keep that attractive smile on my face to look more handsome. So what he has noticed that when he smiles, he looks beautiful. So he has made another decision that he will always wear that smile on his face forever in order to look handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor too on top of it. It means he is repeating all this. He is a bachelor and he is a doctor. What it means? It means that he is admirer of his own beauty. These are the two main reasons why he wants to look beautiful. Again came that noise from above. So again he heard that noise, but he was so engrossed in his looks only, to view his looks into the mirror, that he has completely forgotten what this noise is made up of or who is making this noise. Still two students entered into the room. Let me check out. So I got up, paced up down the room. Then another lovely thought struck me. So he was moving up to and fro, means from one side to the another in the room, because he was not able to pass his time. He was not feeling sleepy. So then another lovely thought struck me. Then because he was free mind, then another important thought came into his mind. I would marry. Yes. Finally, he has decided that he should get married. I would get married to a woman doctor who had plenty of money and a good medical practice. Naturally, a doctor would like to marry a woman who would be similar in profession and who would also be sound in her practice. So what he thought that he could get married to a woman doctor. To whom he should get married? To a woman doctor and who had plenty of money. It means that he is finding a prop or he is finding someone who could get him rid of his, you can say, party. Of his struggling days, who could have enough of money and a good medical practice. Naturally, if a person will have a good medical practice, he will have plenty of money. She had to be fat for a very reason. But he thought that I should not marry a thin or lean woman. I should marry a fat woman. He thought that, but there must be a reason for this. What's the reason? If I made some silly mistake and needed to run away, she should not be able to run after me and catch me. So humorous. He thought that if he would make any mistake and the person and his wife would try to run after him, she would not be able to run if she would be a fat woman. This is the reason why he wanted a fat wife. So, with such thoughts in my mind, I resumed my seat in the chair in front of the table. again he was thinking about all these things, and he was so engrossed, so deeply, you can say deeply set up in his thoughts, that he was not able to look around what is happening around him, what is going on around him. So what has happened? So with such thoughts in my mind, I resumed my seat. He sat on the chair again in front of the table. There were no more sounds from above. But now everything got silent. There were no sounds from above. Suddenly there came a dull thud as if a rubber tube had fallen to the ground. See, what kind of sound was produced? As if some rubber tube, it has been thrown from a height, and thud type of sound was produced. What was that? Surely nothing to worry about. He thought, no, there is nothing to worry about. He thought that maybe a rat or something has fallen down from the roof. Even so, I thought I would turn around and take a look. He thought that I should turn around and have a look. No sooner had I turned than a fat snake wriggled over the back of the chair and landed up on my shoulder. See? So as soon as he turned his face back, he has noticed that a snake, fat snake, cobra snake, it has wriggled with his movements. It has came onto the back of the chair and it has sat up on his shoulder. The snake's landing on me and my turning were simultaneous. As soon as he turned, immediately the snake lands. So I didn't jump, I didn't tremble. So you can very well imagine that what kind of condition would that be if you would have encountered this kind of situation. So he thought that at that moment I didn't move even, and I didn't tremble, shake, because if any kind of vibration or movement in the body has to be made, it must prove fatal for him. Maybe the snake would feel that and would react. So this is the reason he was not able to show any kind of change in his body. I didn't cry out even. There was no time to do any such thing. And he also did not cry up because he thought that there was no time to do any such thing. The snake slithered. Slithered means crawling movement. Slithered along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. So now the snake from the chair, it has come onto his left arm. And it has coiled around his arm here in this area, the part of the arm above the elbow. It has coiled around. See, you can very well imagine the situation of the person at that time. How he would have felt at that time. So, I don't know why students are entering so late. There must be unstable connection on their part. I think so. Next. The hood was spread out and its head was hardly 3 or 4 inches from my face. So hood means the upper part of the snake, including his mouth. It was completely spread out like a fan. And there was just a distance of only 3 to 4 inches between the snake as well as that of the narrator. It means that he was facing death in front of him. It would not be correct to say merely that I sat there holding my breath. He said, if I say that I was standing there just holding my breath, it was not at all wrong. So, I was turned to stone. So he said, I was turned to stone means without any movement, without any feeling, he has turned into a stone. But my mind was very active. The door opened into the darkness. Mind was working. Now he was in his mind, he was thinking that what he should do in order to get rid of the snake. And moreover, he was also thinking of the consequences that if the snake would bite him, what type of medicine he would take and whether he should have that medicine in his room or not. But his mind was very active. Now, the door opened into the darkness. The room was surrounded by darkness. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. Stone image means like a, he has turned to a stone, but his body was covered with flesh. So very beautiful expressions the narrator has used here. I don't know what's the problem with Vanshika and Archita. They are not being able to enter the room. They are joining since a long time. I'm admitting them again and again. So, now, no other option in front of him. At that moment, when you are facing death, what you will remember at first point? What thought came to your mind at once? It is, of course, that of God. And the similar thing has happened with him. I felt then the great presence of the creator of this world and this universe. So at that moment, he has felt only the presence of God, that now only God can save me and help him out. God was there. Suppose I said something and he did not like it. I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, "Oh God." So, see that how he was remembering God at that time. He said, it seems that maybe while I was thinking about my looks and about my decisions of life, maybe God has not liked something. This is the reason, in order to punish me, he has sent a snake to make me feel that death is near you. So in his imagination, on his heart, he was feeling that he was writing the words, "Oh God." There was some pain in my left arm. Why there was pain in his left arm? It was as if a thick leaden rod, a rod made of molten fire, molten means liquid fire, was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. So the snake was squeezing his arm. So he was feeling it was like that, that the snake, it was coiling around. It was like a leaden rod. Leaden means very heavy metal. Okay. And ultimately, because the snake with his, you can say, squeezing power is squeezing his arm. And it means that the snake is making its grip strong. And he said, no, but it was not like that of lead. It was like that. It was fiery hot also, because the heat was generated. Ultimately, how heat? Because from the, you can say, movement of the snake also. And moreover, because of the fiery sensation that he was feeling, because the snake has wriggled around his chair. So he was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. He was feeling that the snake is crushing his arm. The arm was beginning to be drained of all strength. What could I do? And it seemed that this arm, it has drained his complete, you can say, strength. It is devoid of any strength because it has turned to be numb. No circulation of blood. When no circulation of blood is there, your body turns out to be numb. So at my slightest movement, the snake would strike me. Death lurked 4 inches away. So he knew that if he would make even the slight movement, the snake would sense it and ultimately react in biting me. And death was just 4 inches away from him. Why he said that death was just 4 inches away from him? It is just because of the reason that the distance of the snake from his face was just 3 to 4 inches. Suppose it struck, what was the medicine I had to take? Now he was thinking, as he has told, that his body has turned into stone, but his mind was very active. So he said that if the snake would bite me, what medicine I should take? There were no medicines in the rooms. He was thinking of his silliness, that how silly he is. Being a doctor, he has not kept all the medicines at home. So he thought that there were no medicines in the room. I was but a poor, foolish and stupid doctor. He was thinking that he was just a poor and stupid doctor. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly. Feebly means weakly at myself. At that moment, he was so helpless that he had nothing to do with himself except to smile at his silliness. So he was just smiling at his silliness, that what kind of, you can say, silly doctor he was, that he has not kept enough medicines at home. He has not kept any medicine, if any kind of, you can say, if any kind of danger or such kind of impending danger would inflict him. Now, it seemed as if God appreciated that. So he was thinking that God has given him punishment and has appreciated this kind of situation. The snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. Finally, the snake has moved onto the table, and what it was doing, it has turned its head towards the mirror and it was looking into the mirror at its reflection. I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror. He said, I cannot claim that I had ever seen any snake who is just looking into the mirror. But if it was certain that the snake was looking into the mirror, was it admiring its own beauty? Now the poor narrator was thinking that what the snake is looking into the mirror. When the snake is looking into the mirror, what it is admiring? Is it looking at it in? Is it looking at its own reflection, or is it? You can say, is it admiring its own beauty? See, you can see the picture on the screen. So, was it trying to make an important decision about growing a mustache or using eyeshadow or mascara and wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead? Well, you know what is vermilion? Vermilion is bright red color. Here it refers to sindoor. So again, a humorous instant, it has been depicted that the narrator was thinking that what the snake is looking into the mirror. Is it looking for something to increase, to enhance its beauty in order to wear a mascara, in order to wear a vermilion spot on its head, or to wear eyeshadow? It means that such deadly situation in which he was afraid, he did not know that the next moment whether he would be alive or dead. At that moment also, he was just making fun of the situation. So, I did not know anything for certain, he said, but I did not know what is going on in front of me. What sex was there? Was this snake? Was it male or female? Again, he was thinking that whether this snake was male or female, even he did not know. So, I will never know, for the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered into my lap. See, it has uncoiled itself from the arm and it has come into its lap. Uski god mein aa gaya snake. And from there, it crept onto the table and moved towards the mirror. And from there, the snake has gone over the table and looked into the mirror again. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection at closer quarters. Maybe the snake likes to enjoy, or snake likes to enjoy its own reflection in the mirror. So, I was no mere image cut in granite. Now, he showed some moment in order to save himself. He said, at that moment, I was not like any image which was cut out of granite, very hard stone. I was suddenly a man of flesh and blood. Now, I started movement. It means he was a man of flesh and blood. Still holding my breath, I got up from the chair. I quietly went through the door into the veranda. So finally, he has to run away from there. He got up from the chair and quietly he went through the door into the veranda so that he can get rid of the snake. From there, it leapt into the yard and ran for all I was worth. And then finally, he went into the yard and he started running so that he could be saved in his only vest that he was wearing without any clothes. So, phew, expression. Each of us heaved a sigh of relief. Then he thought, I felt relieved that I got rid of that snake. Suddenly, somebody asked, Doctor, is your wife very fat? So when he was narrating the incident, so see, a curious person, he has asked him, sir, so finally you got married. Your wife is fat or thin? No, God willed otherwise. My life companion is thin, reedy person with the gift of a sprinter. Sprinter means who can run very fast. So he said, no, I did not marry a fat woman. She's quite thin and reedy, lean woman. And moreover, she has the quality of her good running skills. Someone else asked, doctor, when you ran, did the snake follow you? Somebody asked, when you ran, the snake followed you. So the doctor replied, I ran and ran till I reached a friend's house. Immediately, I smeared oil all over myself and took a bath. Then finally, what he did, he said, He said, but I ran and ran to reach my friend's house. There, I covered my entire body with oil so that if any toxins are to be attached to the body, they can be mixed with the oil. And finally, I took a bath. I changed into fresh clothes. Next morning at about 8:30, I took my friend and one or two others to my room to move my things from there. Finally, he thought, no, I would no longer stay there. So next morning at 8:30 with his friend and one or two other friends, he has gone there in order to move his things from that place. But then what happened? But we found we had little to carry, but somebody has some things, they have entered his room and ultimately they have taken all the things away and left very few things there. But we found we had little to carry. Some thief had removed most of my things. The room had been cleaned out. Cleaned out means all the things had been taken away by the thief. But not really. The thief had left behind one thing as a final insult. What was that? He said, my vest, the dirty one. See how funny again? So now he said that the thief has taken almost all the things away from that room. But finally, he has left with one thing. Another curious person said, sir, what? What was that the thief left? He said, my vest, which was dirty one, not so white, as he has mentioned in the starting. The fellow had such a sense of cleanliness. He was thought that the thief had sense of cleanliness because it was not so clean. This is the reason he thought that it is a dirty one and he has left it there. So the rascal could have taken it and used it after washing with soap and water. So with this insulting remark, he said he would have taken it, that vest also. He would have cleaned it out with soap and water and must have used it. Did you see the snake the next day, doctor? Somebody said, have you ever seen the snake the next day? The doctor laughed. I had never seen it since. It was a snake which was taken with its own beauty. Was taken means attracted. So now finally what he said that actually I have never seen that snake again. It was a snake and which was taken by its own beauty. So finally the narrator has completely translated how small the incident is. See, snake entered his room. It has coiled around his arm, came into his lap, stood in front of the mirror, and finally left from that place. So finally, what it means that he has how deeply and with clarity has mentioned all the changes in it. So this is all about the chapter, The Snake and the Mirror. And tomorrow, we will discuss the question answers of the chapter. Okay, so if you have any doubt, now you can ask me.